the firstborn of all creation, in every way the primacy is his.
He is the firstborn of all creation, in every way the primacy is his.
Let us give thanks to the Father for having made you worthy to share the lot of the saints in light.
He rescued us from the power of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of his beloved Son.
Through him we have redemption, the forgiveness of our sins.
He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creatures.
In him everything in heaven and on earth was created, things visible and invisible.
All were created through him, all were created for him.
He is before all else that is. In him everything continues in being.
It is he who is head of the body, the church. He who is the beginning, the firstborn of the dead, so that primacy may be his in everything.
It pleased God to make absolute fullness reside in him, and by means of him to reconcile everything in his person,
both on earth and in the heavens, making peace through the blood of his cross.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
He is the firstborn of all creation. In every way, the primacy is his.
Be kind to one another, compassionate, and mutually forgiving, just as God has forgiven you in Christ. Be imitators of God as his dear children. Follow the way of love, even as Christ loved you. He gave himself for us as an offering to God, a gift of pleasing fragrance.
In this passage from the letter to the Ephesians, St. Paul is reminding us to love one another as Christ loves us. How do we love one another? Quite simply, to love is to want the good, to will the good of the other. For that's how God loves us. When we love one another, we want their good. And the good, the love that God has for us in our good is salvation. For Jesus Christ, our Savior and Redeemer, gave his life away for you and for me out of love. He was willing to die so that we could know forgiveness of our sins. Brothers and sisters, as we're progressing in this last week of Lent, this fifth week of Lent, let us examine our consciences. Are there people we have not forgiven? For we're called to forgive one another, as the scriptures abundantly remind us. But we know to forgive one another is difficult. It's not easy. When someone hurts us or says something about us, what's the natural reaction? I'm going to get back at them. I'm going to seek revenge. But brothers and sisters, that never ends well. And that's certainly not what we are called to do as disciples of Jesus Christ. Just as God loves us and gave his life on the cross for us, forgiving us our sins, so too we must learn to forgive one another. I invite you tonight, if there's someone that you're holding a grudge against, if there is someone that you're angry with, come before the Lord and forgive them. Let go of it. Only when you forgive is your heart open to receive the healing and peace that God wants to give you. And let's make this an opportunity as we're in the midst of this pandemic. Let's not be thinking about ourselves, but how can we serve our neighbor? Let's check up on one another. Call a relative, call a friend. See if they're all right. Especially those of our older brothers and sisters, check on them. Perhaps offer, can you do something for them? Maybe go get some groceries for them. We have many opportunities during this pandemic to show our faith, to demonstrate our faith in Jesus Christ, and to come closer to Him, opening our hearts more fully to His love.
Why are you bent on killing me when I have told you the truth?
Why are you bent on killing me when I have told you the truth?
My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For He has looked with
He has filled the hungry with good things.
that justice may reign.
Father of all holiness, you gave us Christ as the shepherd of our souls. Stay with your shepherds and the flock entrusted to them. Do not leave this flock without the loving care of its shepherd.
Do not leave your shepherds without an obedient flock to follow them.
Teach Christians to help the weak with loving care,
and in serving them to serve your Son.
Gather into your church those who do not yet believe,
and help them to build it up by good deeds done for your glory.
Help us to turn to you for forgiveness.
And as you forgive us, reconcile us also with your church.
May the dead pass from this world to eternal life,
to be with you forever.
Pater noster, qui es in caelis, sanctificetur nomen tuum.
May our worship of this
Blessed be God.
Blessed be God.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be his most sacred heart.
Blessed be his most sacred heart.
Blessed be his most precious blood.
Blessed be his most precious blood.
Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Consoler.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Consoler.
Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary, most holy.
Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary, most holy.
Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception.
Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception.
Blessed be her glorious assumption.
Blessed be her glorious assumption.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.
Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse.
Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse.
Blessed be God in his angels and in his saints.
Blessed be God in his angels and his saints.
Ave Regina Caelorum, Ave Domina Angelorum, Salve Radix, Salve Porta, Ex qua mundo lux est orta, Gaude Virgo Gloriosa, Super Omnes Speciosa,
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.